Hello friends, this is Sai Prakash. In the previous session, we have discussed about Telegen's theorem, problems related to Telegen's theorem by taking the examples of the bulbs in the series and parallel connection. In this session, I would like to discuss about power equation or equivalent power regarding bulbs in the series and parallel connection. Before this, please go through the previous video for the better understanding. In this session, I would like to give the relations of the voltage and power and resistance when they are connected in the series. At the end of the session, I will give you important questions regarding this topic. Please comment in the comment box or you can use the group link in the description. Relations when bulb connected in the series. For the better understanding, I am taking you the yesterday's problem. From yesterday's problem, we have a power rating of bulb 1 equal to 90 watts, that is PR1 equal to 90 watts. Power rating of bulb 2 equal to 60 watts. Whereas voltage rating of bulb 1 equal to bulb 2 equal to supply voltage. VR1 equal to 230 volts. VR2 equal to 230 volts. And supply voltage V equal to 230 volts. Resistance of bulb 1, that is R1, equivalent to 587.77 ohms, and resistance of bulb 2 equal to 881.66 ohms. And coming to the voltage of bulb 1 equal to 88.165 volts, whereas voltage drop across bulb 2 equal to 132.249 volts, whereas power consumed by the bulb 1 equal to 13.22 watts. Power consumed by the bulb 2 equal to 19.837. From this, whereas equivalent power equal to P1 plus P2, that is equivalent to inaccurate 36 watts. Approximately we have got P equivalent equal to 34.5 watts. This is because I have taken only two digits after the point for the current I. Actual current is 0.156 amperes. If I take I equal to 0.156 amperes, I will get 36 watts. If I take I equal to 0.15, I will get 34.5 watts. Here you can see that bulb with higher rating have less resistance and bulb with lower rating have high resistance. So P rating of the bulb is inversely proportional to resistance, and the resistance is proportional to the voltage drop across the bulbs. Resistance of the bulb 1 equal to 587.77, where the voltage is 88.165. Resistance of bulb 2 equal to 881.66 ohms and voltage drop is 132.249. So you can see that resistance is proportional to voltage, and voltage is power is also proportional to voltage from these two equations. So PR is proportional to inversely proportional to resistance and inversely proportional to voltage and inversely proportional to power consumed by the bulbs, whereas this is power rating of the bulb. By the Telegen's theorem, we know that power absorbed equal to power delivered. Please don't add these both, 90 plus 60 equal to 150. This is not P equivalent because these both are not the actual power drawn by the bulbs. These are only power ratings. The actual power drawn by the bulb 1 equal to 13.22 watts and actual power consumed by the bulb 2 is equal to 19.837 watts. So, by the Telegen's theorem, V into I equivalent power equivalent to power delivered. Power delivered equal to P1 plus P2. That is equivalent to 13.22 less 19.837 watts. That is equivalent to 34.5 watts by the Telegen's theorem. This is the relation. Whereas this is the resistance of the bulb. R defines resistance of the bulb. Whereas V defines voltage drop across bulb. Whereas P defines power consumed by the bulb. And PR defines power rating of the bulb. Again, I am saying you friends, please don't add this both and tell that this is the total power. This is not the actual power consumed by the two bulbs. This is only the rating of the bulbs. Friends, power equivalent when the bulbs connected in the series. I told you according to the relation, power rating is inversely proportional to resistance and inversely proportional to voltage drop across the bulb and inversely proportional to power consumed by the bulb. From this, from the relations, power rating of the bulb 1, PR1, is greater than power rating of bulb 2. And coming to the voltage, voltage drop across bulb 1 is less than voltage drop across bulb 2, and resistance of bulb 1 is less than resistance of the bulb 2. And coming to the power, power of bulb 1 is less than power consumed by the bulb 2. You know that P average is equal to V square divided by RT. RT is the R equivalent. As they are connected in the series, R equivalent equal to R1 plus R2. That is equivalent to V square divided by R1 plus R2. We know that R1 equal to voltage square divided by power. This is power rating of the bulb 1, and R2 equal to V square divided by power rating of the bulb 2. So, I am substituting R1 and R2 in this formula. So, from this, V square divided by R1 equal to V square divided by PR1, and R2 equal to V square divided by PR2. I am taking common V square, so V square divided by 1 by PR1 plus 1 by PR2 equal to P average. V square cancel, P average equal to 1 by PR1 plus 1 by PR2. By solving this, we will get 1 by P average equal to 1 by PR1 plus 1 by PR2. So P average equivalent to PR1 into PR2 divided by PR1 plus PR2. By solving this, we will get this. I have taken these relations from the previous problem. Power equivalent when bulbs are connected in parallel. From the yesterday, power rating of the bulb 1 is PR1, that is equal to 90 watts, and PR2 of 60 watts, power rating of bulb 2. And the voltage rating of bulb 1 equal to 230 volts, and voltage rating of bulb 2 equal to 230 volts, and given supply is of 230 volts. Here you can see that power consumed by the bulb equal to 90 watts, power consumed by the bulb 2 equal to 60 watts. Therefore, power consumed by the bulb 1 equal to 90 watts and power consumed by the bulb 2 equal to 60 watts. Here you can take that by the Telegen's theorem, power consumed equal to power delivered. Power consumed is also known as power observed. So 90 plus 60, that is equivalent to 150 watts. In parallel, P equivalent equal to P1 plus P2. This is power consumed by the bulb 1, this is power consumed by the bulb 2. In this, power consumed by the bulb 1 is also equivalent to rating of the bulb 1. Power consumed by the bulb 2 equal to power rating of the bulb 2. So total P equivalent equal to PR1 plus PR2 in parallel. So when coming to the parallel, you can add the ratings directly for finding the power equivalent. When coming to the series connection of the bulb, we have to use the P equivalent formula. P equivalent equal to PR1 into PR2 divided by PR1 plus PR2. Friends, for this question, this is bulb 1 and this is bulb 2, and power rating of bulb 1 equal to 100 watts and voltage rating of 230 volts, and power rating of bulb 2 equal to 100 watts and voltage rating of bulb 2 equal to 230 volts, and this is the supply voltage of 230 volts. They have given PR1 equal to 100 watts and PR2 equal to 100 watts. This is power rating of bulb 2 and this is power rating of bulb 1. VR1, voltage rating of bulb 1, that is equal to 230 volts, and voltage rating of bulb 2 equal to 230 volts, and supply voltage is of 230 volts. We know as these two bulbs are connected in the series, P equivalent, that is power equivalent, equal to PR1 into PR2 divided by PR1 plus PR2. So 100 into 100 divided by 100 plus 100, that is equal to 100 into 100 divided by 200, 2 50. By solving this, we will get 50 watts. Power rating of two bulbs with 100 watts when they are connected in the series, we will get the power equivalent of 50 watts. Friends, for this question, power rating of bulb 1 equal to 60 watts and voltage rating of bulb 1 equal to 100 watts, and power rating of bulb 2 equal to 60 watts and voltage rating of bulb 2 equal to 100 volts, and supply voltages of 100 volts. These two bulbs are connected in the parallel. So whenever they are connected in parallel, power equivalent equal to PR1 plus PR2, where PR1 is power rating of bulb 1 and PR2 is power rating of bulb 2. Therefore 60 plus 60, that is equal to 120 watts. When 60 watts bulb and 60 watts bulb is connected in parallel, we will get the equivalent power of 120 watts. Friends, this is the first question I would like to give you. This is the second question I would like to give you, and this is the third question. Please do this question and comment the answer in the comment box. I hope you enjoy the video. Thank you, friends.
This is Sai Prakash signing off. Please stay tuned to our channel. Please do like, share and comment for the video if you like the video. Please click on the bell icon for more updates. Please watch the classes regularly. If you have any doubt, please comment in the comment box or you can use the group link in the description, friends. Thank you for watching the video.